worst rated nursing homes in the country are going into a special watch list, a program designed to help them get better. But our national investigative team finds homes with little improvement spending years in the program. Here's Investigate TV's Lee Zurich with Listed.
Raised six kids, me and my mom, very religious. He loved his family.
Charles Stem loved the beach, California, and telling a good story.
Very outgoing.
But family members say his life ended because of a short stay at a nursing home, Touchstone Healthcare Community.
The condition that he was in was unimaginable.
After about 1 month here, he had to be taken by ambulance to hospice care. Charles Stem died 2 months shy of his 78th birthday.
Do you think he would still be alive right now if he would have been somewhere else and not there?
Absolutely. Because he was thriving at the hospital.
Touchstone Healthcare Community is on a nursing home list reserved for as many as the 88 worst facilities in the country, what's called the Special Focus Facility Program. In 1987, Congress designed the Special Focus Facility Program to provide additional oversight and penalties for nursing homes with a persistent record of poor care for at least 3 years.
Are nursing homes getting better because they're a part of this program?
No, I don't think the Special Focus Facility has achieved its goal.
Instead, federal records show problems persist at these homes. Our analysis shows as of August, the more than 80 facilities in the program have had an average of 20 complaints in the past 3 years. The federal government claims it takes homes about 18 months to come into compliance and move out of this program. But we found 24% of those on the list had been there longer.
If the facility is still a special facility program for a long time, it tells you that it has not, the program has not really achieved its goal. The facility is still providing poor care, very poor care to a lot of residents.
The president of a nursing industry association agrees the program has good intentions, but is limited in its effectiveness because the government punishes homes with fines instead of working with them to be better.
The only way you get off the list is that you have to be incredibly good during the survey process. You get surveyed twice as often as a regular facility, and you have to do much better. Again, in principle, that's a good idea, but only if they're given the resources and the help to get better, and they're not given anything.
The program has more challenges. Funding from the federal government is limited. It's capped at 88 nursing homes, so many homes that deserve to be in the program can't get any extra oversight. A program Beth Thiem would argue didn't help improve her own father's care.
And how someone can do that to another human being and treat them with no care. It's, I have no words.
Lee Zurich, Valley News Live.
Now, locally, the Moorhead Rehabilitation and Healthcare Center is part of the program. It's had 12 substantiated complaints in the last 3 years and was not fined. Touchstone was the only facility that responded to our team's request for comment. Executive Director Timothy Cook said Touchstone has been making major progress to address problems found during inspections and that it continues to strive to elevate care of residents. Charles Stem's family recently received a letter in August from the state of Iowa. That letter says inspectors substantiated their complaints. You can watch part two of this series tomorrow night on Valley News Live at 10. Well, there's little reason to worry you'll become sick with COVID from food you eat or handle. That's according to an international committee that studied if coronavirus might be carried on food or its packaging. The committee said in a statement there is no documented evidence that food is a significant source or vehicle for transmission of COVID. The organization went on to say it's possible people could eat something contaminated with the virus and become infected, but so far, no cases of that have been confirmed. Some countries have restricted food imports, tested imported products, or asked companies to state that their products are coronavirus-free, but the International Committee says that's not necessary. New CDC research shows that younger workers are more likely to be injured on the job compared to older workers. Between 2012 and 2018, more than 3 million employees between the ages of 15 and 24 went to the ER for work-related injuries. Boys and workers ages 18 or 19 years had the highest injury rate. Those in trade, transportation, and utilities were more likely to have injuries that required at least one day away from the job. The leading cause of injuries is contact with objects and equipment. Well, it's game week in the NFL. Next in sports, we'll hear from Minnesota Vikings head coach Mike Zimmer on the first week of this odd season.